Welcome to another video from explainingcomputers.com and to a special extra episode about the Raspberry Pi 4 Model B. Yes, in late June 2019, the Raspberry Pi Foundation have surprised us with a new Pi, and I'm very grateful they've sent me one to take a look at. Now, you'll be pleased to hear that the Raspberry Pi 4B is a very significant upgrade while still maintaining backwards compatibility with previous models. So let's go and take a closer look. So this is going to be a video full of surprises. And the first one is this. This is a very large box, isn't it? This is the Raspberry Pi 4B desktop kit. And this contains all the things you need to start using a Raspberry Pi 4B as your desktop computer. And this costs £105 or $120. But do not fear, you can still buy an individual Raspberry Pi 4B. But because I've been sent this rather nice desktop kit, obviously we'll start by looking at this. So let's open it up. And here we are, nice and easy to get inside. And there we are. And oh, straight away, we can see Raspberry Pi stuff. Here we have in the middle a Raspberry Pi official case, which contains the Raspberry Pi 4B. We'll look at that in a lot more depth, obviously, a bit later in the video. And in addition to that, we have a Raspberry Pi mouse, and we have a new Raspberry Pi USB-C power supply. Yes, the Raspberry Pi 4B uses a USB-C power supply. That's one of our first changes to the Pi. And beneath here, this lifts out, I'm sure it does, something like this. Come out, there we are. Oh, under here we've got a Raspberry Pi keyboard and hub. That looks rather nice. And also down here we've got some connection leads. So lots of exciting things in this desktop kit. But I'm sure initially, at least, the thing you're most interested in is the Raspberry Pi 4B itself, which will be inside this case, which I think just clicks apart. There it is. There is the Raspberry Pi 4B. So let's take a closer look at this new Pi. So, I've now put the accessories safely to one side so we can take a closer look at the star of our show, the brand new Raspberry Pi 4B. And the second surprise to reveal here is that you can buy a Raspberry Pi 4B in one of three different versions, because you can buy a Raspberry Pi 4B with either 1, 2 or 4 gigabytes of RAM. And to give you the prices, the 1 gigabyte Raspberry Pi 4B costs £33 or $35. The 2 gigabyte Raspberry Pi 4B costs £43 or $45. And the 4 gigabyte Raspberry Pi 4B costs £53 or $55. So you can make your choice in terms of price, in terms of how much RAM you have on your Raspberry Pi 4B. Now, as you probably noticed already, things have changed a bit on the top of the Pi. The components are slightly different in some cases. So let's compare this to the previous Raspberry Pi 3B Plus. And there we are. The new Pi is now sitting next to its older comrade. And straight away, you can see that they've switched over the position of the USB ports and the Ethernet socket, which is now a mirror of the previous Pi. And we can see we've got our USB-C power connector here compared to the micro USB power connector on previous Pis. And other changes down here, which I'll get to in a second. And what all this means is, whilst the Pi is compatible with previous models, the Raspberry Pi 4B, it's got the same form factor, it won't go in the same cases. We need new cases for the Raspberry Pi 4B. So let's take a bit of a closer look at the specs of this board. And the Raspberry Pi 4B is based on a Broadcom BCM2711 system on a chip with a 64-bit quad-core ARM Cortex-A72 CPU running at 1.5 GHz. As just noted, this is paired with 1, 2 or 4 gigabytes of RAM. That's a low-power DDR4 RAM. And the board also has good wireless connectivity. Specifically, it's got dual-band 802.11b GNNAC Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 5.0. And as you probably noticed, if you're into your Pis, we still have the camera connector and display connector on the top of the board in exactly the same positions they were previously. The MIPI, CSI and DSI connectors are just as we found them on previous Pis. If we turn to the first short edge, things get very exciting, because for the first time on a Pi, we've got gigabit Ethernet. and then our four Type-A USB ports, as you can see here. Two of them, as you've probably noticed already, are USB 3. So yes, we've got two USB 3 ports and gigabit Ethernet on a Pi. So if, for example, you want to use a Pi to build a NAS, that's very good news indeed. Rotating around to the first long edge, we find a familiar 3.5mm jack for audio and composite video output, and then at the other end of this edge, we have our USB-C power connector. And the Raspberry Pi 4B requires 5 volts at least 3 amps, which can be delivered either through this USB-C connector or via GPIO or using a power of Ethernet hat. And then in the middle of those connectors, we find two, count them two, micro HDMI connectors. Yes, the full-size HDMI connector has gone to be replaced with these two micro HDMI ports. And so if you're wondering why there were two leads in the desktop kit, this is why. We now have dual display support on a Raspberry Pi. And these micro HDMI connectors support resolutions up to 4K. And in this context, it's also worth noting that the Raspberry Pi 4B offers hardware decoding of both 1080p and 4K video at up to 60 frames a second. Turning to the second short edge, we find that nothing has changed. We still have a display connector where it was on previous Pis. And similarly, if we turn to the second long edge, we find no changes again. We've got our familiar 40-pin Raspberry Pi GPIO connector and also the 4-pin power over Ethernet or PoE connector first introduced on the Raspberry Pi 3B+. If we move back to the top of the board, and I'll just show you underneath, because of course we do have underneath the micro SD card slot, which obviously we're putting a card in very soon to boot up the Pi, but other than that, nothing of great excitement underneath. And so there we are. That is the spec of our new Raspberry Pi 4B. And just to give you a summary, this is a Raspberry Pi with 1, 2, or 4 gigabytes of RAM, two USB 3 ports, gigabit Ethernet, USB-C power, and dual 4K output. And so I think by anybody's measure, this is a very significant upgrade to the Raspberry Pi. So, let's take a brief look at the Raspberry Pi 4B accessories. And the first of these is the power supply, which we have here. We've already removed it from its little box. And this provides the 5 volts, 3 amps necessary to run the Raspberry Pi 4B with its USB-C connector on the end. And the thing I really like about this, it's got a very, very long lead, which is great to see on a power supply. So often I have to put an extension lead on a power supply for a single board computer. I won't have to do that for this one. It's got a nice long lead. And talking of leads, these are the two HDMI leads that came in the box. They've got the micro HDMI at one end to go into the Pi and full-size HDMI at the other to go into a monitor or a recorder or whatever else you're putting them into. And here again is the case, which we saw earlier. The Pi came in the case, a standard Raspberry Pi case, but obviously redesigned to take the Raspberry Pi 4B, different cutouts to previous cases. And very easy to put the Pi in here. You just literally drop it in like this, and then you drop the cover on the top and it all clips down, if I can get it right. There we are. And the Pi is now easily in the case and you can just put your micro SD card in the back. And that just goes in there, I think, like that. So the Pi is all ready for action. But of course, to use the Pi, it has to have a keyboard and a mouse. And as we saw in the Raspberry Pi kit, there was the Raspberry Pi mouse. This was released earlier, I think, in 2019. You need to bring in a Stanley knife to let us in there. Never seen a Raspberry Pi mouse before in the flesh or the plastic. Although it is, it's got a red scroll. Well, that's rather nicer looking mouse. And finally, we have the Raspberry Pi keyboard and hub, which we will open up via the magic of filmmaking. And it's actually a rather nice keyboard. It's very similar to the keyboard I use a lot of the time. Nice soft keys, very good if you've got arthritis or RSI, things like that. Good spacebar action. And as you can see here, it has got the hub at the back. It's got three USB Type-A ports there. And it plugs into the Pi using this red lead, which goes in like that into micro USB. That will go into the Pi and it gives you the extra USB ports via the hub at the back. So there we are. It's now time to put all of this together and to boot up the Raspberry Pi 4 Model B. B. So, here we are booting into Raspbian on the Raspberry Pi 4B. And this is a new version of Raspbian released concurrently with the Raspberry Pi 4B to support, obviously, its new hardware. And in fact, what I'm running here is probably a pre-release because I've been supplied this before release day. And I don't necessarily have everything here, I don't think. And if we look into programming, stuff is there, internet. We don't have, for example, LibreOffice installed here. So this might not be final software. I don't know. So I don't want to judge it too much on that. And because of that, I'm therefore not going to do significant performance tests in this video. I will leave those to future videos. But it's interesting, I think, to look here. We go to Accessories and Task Manager, and you'll see that we've got our, well, 3731 megabytes of RAM there. This is a 4 gigabyte Raspberry Pi 4B. The other memory is being used by the GPU here. If I go to Preferences and Pi Configuration, you'll see my GPU is allocated 256 megabytes, which we can do on a Pi with a 4 gigabytes of RAM. I've still got to get my head around the fact we can now buy Raspberry Pis with 1, 2, or 4 gigabytes of RAM. And talking of the GPU will make you start to think about graphical performance. Let's just have a little bit look at that. Let's go into the Chromium web browser. And here we are. We can clearly do normal web browsing very well indeed. I'll have to upgrade my SBC page here, won't I? Put the Raspberry Pi 4B at the top of that page there. And if we go to, say, YouTube and play a sample clip, I know that's what you all want to see me do. We'll just full screen that, and hopefully it'll catch up. There we are. This will be playing in 1080p, I think. Yes, this is 1080p. And this looks pretty good. This is much better than we'd normally see on a Raspberry Pi, isn't it? This is rather good playback. And that's clearly a very good thing. Raspberry Pis have struggled a bit with media playback for a while now, and this clearly, with this latest upgrade, we aren't going to have that problem anymore. So that's very good to see. And I think for now I'm going to leave this, because I'm going to come back and do all sorts of tests in future videos, tests of cooling and performance and all that type of thing. But the one thing I would say is that the desktop experience here is just very nice. It's very fluid. And the Raspberry Pi Foundation, in their marketing for the Raspberry Pi 4B, suggests it has performance comparable to entry-level x86 systems. And I think that's a fair comparison to make. And that's not to suggest that a Raspberry Pi 4B is the same as the average desktop PC. It obviously isn't. But if you want to do basic computing on a Raspberry Pi 4B, things like web browsing, bit of media playback, email, bit of office work, that type of thing, it's very much well up to that task. And I'm sure that's why they now sell the Raspberry Pi 4B desktop kit, as we were previously looking at. So there we are. This is Raspbian on the Raspberry Pi 4B. It's always great to see Raspbian running. Regardless, I think it's just a nice operating system to use. And I'll be testing it out a lot more in future videos. The Raspberry Pi 4B is a very significant upgrade that will have a very large impact on the SBC marketplace. Why? Well, because for a few years now, if you've wanted to buy a Pi-priced single-board computer, you've had a trade-off to make. On the one hand, you could have bought a Raspberry Pi, a 3B, a 3B Plus, with fantastic software support, great support for the GPU in the software, not least, and fantastic community support. Or you could have bought a competitor board with far worse software support, far worse community support, but competitor boards have increasingly had features not found on the Pi. Things like a USB 3 ports, gigabit Ethernet, more memory, and 4K output. And so now we've got on a Raspberry Pi, USB 3 ports, gigabit Ethernet, more memory, 4K output. There are far fewer reasons to buy a competitive board. And so the Raspberry Pi 4B could blow many of its competitors out of the market. I very much look forward to testing out the Raspberry Pi 4B in future videos, using it in projects, running performance tests, probably doing a new cooling video. And I'd be very interested to hear what you think of a new Raspberry Pi 4B. What do you plan to do with it? Please let us all know down in the comments section. But now that's it for another video. If you enjoyed what you've seen here, please press that like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And I hope to talk to you again very soon.